What makes you itch? What sort of a situation would you like? Let's suppose, I do this often in vocational guidance of students. They come to me and say, well, we're getting out of college and we have the faintest idea what we want to do. So I always ask the question, what would you like to do if money were no object? How would you really enjoy spending your life? Well, it's so amazing. As a result of our kind of educational system, crowds of students say, well, we'd like to be painters, we'd like to be poets, we'd like to be writers, but as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. Or another person says, well, I'd like to live an out-of-doors life and ride horses. Or say, do you want to teach in a riding school? Let's go through with it. What do you want to do? When we finally got down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that, and forget the money. Because if you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. And after all, if you do really like what you're doing, it doesn't matter what it is, you can eventually become a master of it. The only way to become a master of something is really with it. And then you'll be able to get a good fee for whatever it is. So don't worry too much. Somebody's interested in everything. Anything you can be interested in, you'll find others. But it's absolutely stupid to spend your time doing things you don't like in order to go on spending things you don't like and doing things you don't like, and to teach your children to follow in the same track. See, what we're doing is we're bringing up children and educating them to live the same sort of lives we're living, in order that they may justify themselves and find satisfaction in life by bringing up their children, to bring up their children to do the same thing. So it's all wretch and no vomit. It never gets there. And so, therefore, it's so important to consider this question, what do I desire?
If they understand that, then they can be wise and be teachers.
they don't understand that in every town. To be wise, you have to, that's the meaning of the saying that to enter the kingdom of heaven, you have to become again as a child. From the child's point of view, the things which the adult considers irrelevant to survival are perfectly important. And so children collect pebbles and colored glass and all sorts of trivia which they consider as precious as diamonds. The adults are both. They really have this. Now, the child, as child, doesn't know how to play the adult's game, which is a power game. And so has to be educated to learn the values of the power game, to learn what's what and what is important. But when he has mastered that game, he realizes it has no rewards. That all the things that the adults thought they were gaining by their power game are, after all, not worth having. That's why you can be rich and miserable. So that having learned and having seen through the adult power game, you come back to the point of the child. Now I think that this is the greatest possible lesson for the Western world to learn, because we are so hung up on the idea of power, of control, of being able to make everything go the right way. And we never thought it through. When you get control of it, what are you going to do? Because the moment you have a situation where you are really in control of things, that is to say, in which the future is almost completely predictable. You will see, as I said last night, that a completely predictable future is already the past. You've had it. That's not what you wanted.